Hi, I'm Bethany Maddox Sands, and I'm going straight from the court to the bar, mixing a couple drinks for ladies' night here. This is a little drink I call Dancing Queen. I hope you all like mezcal.
We love it.
Done. All right, and I'm pouring doubles, if everyone's okay with this.
Sounds like it.
All right, perfect. Let's get started.
So tell us about this mezcal.
So this mezcal is actually, it's an añejo, okay. So it's an aged drink, and that's why you see the coloration a little bit, but we also have a reposado. Our blanco is a little smoky, if you like a little smoke in your drink, but this one is nice and smooth.
So you've traveled all over the world. What's been one of your favorite places for food?
Favorite places? You follow me on Instagram? Follow my foodie account? All right, so I'm a big foodie. I actually like to get immersed in every country and region I go to. So when I'm in Thailand, I'm eating a lot of Thai food. When I go to South America, Peruvian food's amazing. Indian food is unreal. So I at least go local when I'm traveling. But if I had to pick a favorite other than my hometown in Arizona, because it's nice to be home, I would say Thai or Indian. I think it's my favorite right now. All right, so right here, if I can get this open, we're just gonna unscrew this, I think. That's how it's gonna work. So this is some celery simple syrup. This is a refreshing cocktail. So I put the mezcal in. I'm gonna make a mess, but we're gonna roll. Little
now,
syrup.
I need to know about your skirt that you're wearing. It looks so comfortable. The pattern's so cute. Tell me all about it.
Yes, this is my Lucky in Love maxi skirt. So it's the same materials as all the skirts that you see me on the court with.
Okay.
It has the undershorts, same high-waisted band, colorful. But you can kind of wear it, it's like work play kind of look. So you can wear it out. You can play tennis in this. It's all athletic gear, it's all athletic material. You can move around in it. If you get used to the long feeling on your legs, then you'll love it. But otherwise, I just change up the shoes and then go out from there. Technically, I didn't change up my shoes, so I'm totally, I'm legit going from the court to the bar. So, all right, a couple celery bitters. Y'all like grapefruit too, right?
Yeah, definitely.
All right, there we go.
Sounds super refreshing. You've been on the road for the last 9 weeks.
Yes.
How do you pack to travel that long?
How do I pack? I should probably ask the people around me, how do I pack? In all honesty, packing is probably my most stressful thing I can think of, especially when I'm gone for 9 weeks, coordinating outfits, shoes, enough laundry. I mean, you have all your snacks. I mean, when I'm gone for that long, I pack protein shakes, oatmeal, racket gear, grips. I have a checklist. I'm actually very organized. So I have a checklist, something that you guys maybe didn't know. I travel with a bed. So
what?
A little high maintenance, maybe, but it's probably the best travel investment I've made in my life. So let's get this on. Technical difficulties. Here we go. Boom. But if that makes me high maintenance,
you gotta sleep well.
Oh well, yeah. And my silk pillowcase. Don't judge me. All right, here we go.
More fashion questions for you.
Done.
We know you love fashion. Who inspires you off the court?
Off the court?
Yeah.
I think some of my favorite designers right now, I'll tell you my favorite designer, she always comes up with something colorful, Allison Olivia.
Okay.
I think she always comes up with something new. She has a ton of selection. There's another designer called Millie in New York City that I always stop by. But I watch a lot of the runway shows, so New York Fashion Week. I look at a lot of what the models are wearing on the street. I get a lot of inspiration from everywhere. I don't really like to follow one style even. I think when you go over to a place like, for example, Hong Kong, I think the style there is so different. I think they're a little bit ahead of us. Like it's like watching a runway on the street. It's super cool. And then you go to Paris, it's a little bit more discreet, a little more casual. And then obviously you have LA to New York is completely different too. So I like getting a little bit of inspo from everywhere. All right, so finally, we're gonna add a little bit of seltzer water, grapefruit flavored. Then I think we're ready to roll.
Yes.
Cheers to this. All right, let me know.
Thank you.
It's the first time I've made this for someone other than myself, so.
Well, we're excited to try. Thanks for joining us.
Of course.
Cheers.
She's delicious.
Did you see our faces?
We're all excited, Alex.
I'm not sure how this is.
This is really tasty.
We all went in for a second sip, so that's a good sign.
Hubs, you'd be proud of me.
The celery works.
Celery's delicious, right?
To be honest, I'm a little unsure.
Yeah. I can tell you, Andrew, you're like watching me put all the celery bitters
maybe
in.
Maybe because I made the celery and I was like,
No, it's delicious. Right. This is perfect. All right.
Boom.
Ladies' so night.
We did it.
TW.
And for more recipes, go to toastworld.com.
For more mezcal recipes, check out my Instagram.
Can the camera guys get in?
Yeah! Break that fourth wall.
Hubs, Hubs, you want to try? Get a taste test? This is the ultimate judge right here.
That's craftsmanship.
Yeah, you have this on camera, right? Justin telling me I did well.
You salt the rim and like a little bit of like chili pepper and salt. With that and celery stock, it works out really well.
All right, I got requests for another round. So apparently it was delicious. So I'm gonna make some more double shots for everyone behind the scenes.
Yeah.
This has been fun, guys.
Yeah,
it's always fun. TW on the court, off the court, late at night. We do it all.
Beth, you do it all.
I wear it all. I do it all.
They spill a little.
Listen, I tell my husband every day that he married a unicorn, so I'm just gonna stick by that.
Cheers to unicorns.
Yeah.
Yes, all right. And to everyone knowing it.